put in one place, store it on the little corner of magic ships.
And they're headed this way. Pirates.
A whole ship full of them.
This is just a tiny village. Why would pirates come here?
How should I know? They're coming. Sure is a way to the sea and crash the shore. Pirates are coming here today, so all of you must be careful.
What she's trying to say is that we've got a story to tell. A story that happened over 300 years ago. A story about cutthroat pirates.
And a nice enough English boy about 12 years of age.
Ours is a story about buried treasure.
Lots and lots of pieces of it, and home winds and precious jewels.
Plus, an ocean voyage halfway around the world to find that very great treasure.
Buried treasures are both belong to the meanest, most bloodthirsty buccaneer ever sent to seven seas, Captain Flint. By Blackbeard, the child who next to Captain Flint.
This tale of adventure at sea was written by Robert Louis Stevenson, who wrote that Flint's buried treasure was worth over 700,000 pounds.
Pounds is a unit of English money. In our money today, that buried treasure was silver gains, gold bills, and precious jewels.
And pieces of eight, which are pieces of pure gold.
Flint's buried
The world, the watch, but as far as That's just it, Long John. We don't know where that's no cat.
I can't say that I have. Skeleton. Now, that's a new one to me, sure.
Skeleton animal, Johnny.
There's always somewhere new just to arrive in your serial in 7 seas, Captain.
Pays good aboard my ship, Long John.
I don't know, Captain. Sailing where you're sailing. A secret like himself and crew. Well, we meet up. We just might never return. I got him safely. That himself and Captain Flint.
Captain Flint!
He's the meanest, coolest buccaneer ever set sail.
Captain Flint is what I call a parrot. My feathered friend, Captain Flint.
Aww, he's so many, he's so many.
Captain Flint here could be as much as 200 years old. Parrots live forever. And if anyone's seen more wickedness than the Captain Flint here, it must be the very devil himself. He's been to Madagascar and to Malabar, and then on the serpent. Even seeing some of those murderous things a bird or man could ever see at Portobello.
Stand by the go now.
May your sail that bird of yours.
Now, give me timbers. That he is. As fine as that thing to his name, Captain Flint. And you should hear his language. A little salty.
Ooh, salty, salty. No, never salty.
He never shuts up. Just keeps talking and talking and talking. But that's all he knows, this stupid bird.
Well, Silver, if your parents are impatient, you're sailing and you've sailed enough voyages to crew my ship. What do you say? Are you with us, Long John?
Perhaps if you consider taking along some of the old sailor friends gathered here to smuggle them aboard your ship, Captain.
You're all sailors?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I wish there was some way you could warn him what they really are.
But if we did, how did she never really see the story?
But they're safety pirates, you know.
What's wrong with this picture? It's crude only by
that?
I asked.
I lie, Captain? What'd you say that for?
Big one. Until we get to the Skeleton Island, that's gonna be it. Mine.
Well, that way, mine.
More mine.
Not ours.
I'm assuming Captain.
Thank you.
nothing at all. I took on drug sentences and berries and oysters. Say you want to have and have a piece of cheese about the man.
He's not wrong, not like him. You're being a man. like the water, the treasure.
But I'd like to give you one of them.
As soon as we get all the Flint's treasure loaded on the